Yeah,
I think so.
Hello, everyone. This is me, Dr. Rubenstein, your favorite DJ on Quarantine FM.
Mine too.
You're just talking. Number 21. And I'm super happy and super excited to have Hector Ox over. Hi.
Hi.
come here. Sorry. We've been friends for a while. I think we know each other for like 8 years or something.
Yeah, maybe.
Never played together. Maybe on same parties, but never B2B.
I know, never.
So today's a historical moment.
Yes, yeah.
No, not really, but thanks for coming. Thanks for joining.
Thanks for the invitation.
I really appreciate that you found time in this busy time of pandemic.
Yeah.
That we're all jobless.
I try to look like for one spot in between all my gigs, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I had some things in common, but they all get cancelled.
Yeah.
I think it's for everyone, right? Like now,
exactly.
Right now. Yeah. Wait. We're both a bit nervous.
Yeah.
I am. Yeah, shouldn't be. I'm always nervous. It's number 21. I'm still nervous. Can you imagine? So wait, I prepared questions for you. How long do you live in Berlin?
7 years.
Seven? That's it? I thought longer. For me, it's 8.5. And I remember meeting you, I think maybe at Berghain super long ago, when you just moved here, and you asked if you can send me promos. Or like maybe it was like some new... I remember it so well. Not so well, but...
I can't remember very well. Yeah. But I know that I know you since very long, so...
Yeah. So it's been a while. How do you like it?
Berlin? It's amazing, yeah. Now it's a bit less amazing, but it's still amazing, I guess.
It's more amazing than any other places in the world, trust me. The place to be, I always put this tag when I post something on my social media, Berlin, the place to be, which is a joke, but also not, because it's really the place to be.
I also use it as a joke, or also not sometimes.
I mean, I feel like it's one of the very few places that something is still happening. And quarantine is not so strict, because in many places things are like closed, and here we still have some parties going on.
Yeah, also they have to wear masks on the street.
But yeah, everyone is wearing masks, which is nice that really everyone is obeying it and making it safe to party. Yeah, wait, I have more questions. Do you play vinyl only?
Yes, I do.
Ah, that's nice. Did you always play vinyl only?
For a while, I used to play with real CDs as well.
Oh, but when was it?
Like, I don't know, 2013, 14, 15?
Yeah. You should speak a bit
louder. Okay, sorry.
Not so loud, wait. To be honest, I started as a vinyl only DJ, but then when I started touring, it was just too heavy, and I had to like switch completely. I still play mostly vinyl, but my back hurts all the time still. How's your back?
It's still okay.
Still okay?
It's solid. Yeah.
Are you working out?
A little bit.
Yeah, I don't work out. I only like dance, but I think it's
a kind of workout, I guess.
It doesn't make your back any stronger. Mm. I don't think so. And so it's okay for you to carry all those heavy record bags.
I mean, it has wheels, so I don't have to carry it so much.
I live on the top floor, so...
Ah, yeah, no, that's impossible.
Hector came here and he was like...
Yeah, it's...
Imagine.
It's a fifth or sixth?
Sixth floor, six.
No, with the records, it would be very hard.
I'm like a strong woman, but also, you know, sometimes when I come back from like touring, and sometimes I can pay a taxi driver to like carry my records upstairs, and sometimes like they say no, I can't, because it's Berlin, you know, I'll pay you, and they're like no. So once I stood on the street and I'm like, there is no way that after three gigs I'm carrying my records upstairs, and I just asked a random person on the street, I'm like, I'll give you $10 if you bring my records up. And they did it for free. They did it for free. I was like, I'm so tired, there is no way that I'm doing it. So yeah.
I live on the first, so it's easier.
Lucky, that's why you still can play vinyl only. That's the secret. Yeah. Okay, another question. So you wait, what did I write here? Oh, it's wait, it's for other DJs. Wait, I need to here. Okay, so you have so many projects. It's like you have a gazillion of releases. You are so productive. You have two labels, Oaks and Chaos,
yeah,
and sub-label. And you also do merch and you do everything by yourself. How do you manage?
Well, I wake up early. And
thanks for the tip. I wake up so late. That's why I don't get anything
and
done.
And then I also have some people helping me to do all the stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And they are quite solid. So the most complicated thing was to set it up. And now it's like, fine. Yeah, it's rolling along.
Nice. I have one person helping me out. Lucas, come here. Lucas is still taping. We're like a two women show. Say hi.
Hi guys, happy to see you again.
We are so happy to see you again. Lucas is still taping the lamp there behind the camera. It's like, yeah, oh my God, if only this was the case.
Mm.
Go.
Beautiful.
if only. Yeah, so also you made a... You released an album on Bassiani label.
Yeah.
Was it last year or 2 years ago? When was it?
At the end of 2018, I think.
So like a year and a half, almost 2 years ago.
Yeah.
How long did it take you to work on this album?
I didn't do it in too long, I think. Like,
you just make it like this, super fast.
I do the tracks very fast. Like
plus
in
plus
4 hours.
On plus 8 speed.
Yeah. Or two-step.
Two-step plus 8, okay, got it. Do you have any tips on productivity except of waking up early, because this is not doable?
That's, I mean, you don't have to wake up at 6, but do it at 9:30, 10.
9:30, yeah, I wake up at 12,
yeah,
just because I can.
Lucky you.
Maybe that's why I don't get anything done. I was trying to work on my label for a year. I'm like having it planned and I still don't have anything except of a few tracks that I want to release. But
you have the most important thing, I think.
Yeah, I know. Maybe those people already gave up on waiting. Maybe they took it back. I still have to talk to them,
or more of them are waiting for it.
Maybe, guys, if you are making cool acid, maybe oh my God, this is perfect. You should send it to quarantinefm666@gmail.com if you want to send us promos or some like unreleased tracks or records or nudes, or if you want to date cash for both me and Lucas because we're jobless, or if you want to date Lucas, then you can write to quarantinefm666@gmail.com. Lucas is cute. And you're also part of Heron Sauna crew.
Yeah, I am.
You are the resident of the party.
Yeah, since 2017, 18.
How did that work out for you? You were just friends from the beginning, or?
Yeah, I played in the first. I was actually the first DJ playing in Heron Sauna.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's nice.
I did the opening, the first party, so.
Oh, so it's like symbolic, kind of.
Yeah, and then, I played one time more for them or two, and they asked me to be resident. I was going to every party when I could.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was very natural.
Yeah, that's nice. I love when things just work out on their own. Then it's like when it's more natural and not forced, then they always work better and like it's more exciting, like me and Lucas, right? Just
yeah,
becoming friends. Lucas loves to work on the mic. Come.
What did you want me to say?
I don't know. Ask.
I don't have my lines. We didn't script this.
It's not. You didn't have your lines. We didn't script this. Normally, you love talking on the mic. Okay. What else? What influences you? You know, like your music, your productions.
I just try to get things from my life. I don't know, things that happen to me, and yeah, I mean things I try to get relevant stuff, like
experiences
and so on.
Your tracks always have funny names.
Yeah.
So like some from party life and like.
Yeah.
Like.
I usually start the track with the name, so I know how it has to sound and what it has to tell.
That's interesting. So you just like get an inspiration from like what you want to say and then put it into music.
Exactly.
This is fun. Yeah. Well, so far I made like one track. It is like intro with acid. I'm learning how to make acid lines, and I'm not interested in anything else. I just want to do like acid line on top of acid line on top of acid line.
I think the most complicated thing is to know what you want to do, so go for it.
Yeah, right? I'm just too lazy. I need Lucas to push me. That's my secret of productivity. Lucas tells me, Marina, do this, do this, do this, do this every day. And then 2 months later, I'm doing it finally. Yeah. Okay. I wanted to announce my gig on this Saturday, I think, and it's in Tallinn in a place called Hall. So guys, if you live in Tallinn, please come. I'll play some acid for you. I promise. It's gonna be fun. And do you want to announce anything about your projects, your future releases? What are you working on?
Well,
you want to say hi to your mom.
Yeah, hi to my mom, of course.
What's her name?
Dolores, Lola, Felipe. Well, in Spanish, it's the same name. It's weird.
Yeah.
It's
nice
hello
name,
from
I
your
like it.
Son. Yeah.
Hey, Hector's mom. Hi from Berlin.
Yeah. I will release a couple of records. Yeah, but I think early next year. So I brought I have the test pressing, and I brought them both. So I will play
nice.
Them.
Oh, nice. Let's. Of course, you can also say it in the mic that it's your test pressing.
It's okay. People will find out.
Okay. Shall I play some music? What do you think? You wanted to say something else, Lucas? You wanted to say something else? You have like zero presence this time. I don't know what happened to you. Some like autumn depression because Lucas is such an attention whore normally.
I don't know, maybe I'm just not feeling so great today. But I'm.
Oh, poor Lucas. Invite him for a date.
No.
Okay, so I stopped talking.
Yeah. Enjoy.
I would change the record, but I can't, because all I would change the record, but I can't, because all I hear is my AUX mine, AUX mine, a new my ear. It's my ear. It's
now, why there's is it okay, guys? So we had small technical difficulties, aka I fucked up a little bit, but now we start again. So please stay tuned.
It's my AUX, my AUX, my
be warmer love. It might be ever love. It might be ever love. It might be ever love. Everything you see may not be real. Everything you read may not be true. Everything you hear may not be there. Look inside your soul. Listen to your heart. It might be a mirage. It might be a mirage. It might be a mirage.
Thank you. fucking me? Who's fucking me? Who's fucking me? Who's fucking me? We'll be right back.
Like a natural force. Strange patterns of movement beneath the Earth's surface. Strange patterns of movement. Like a natural force. Strange patterns of movement beneath the Earth's surface.
Thank you.
Oh, wait. No, it's a new mixer. We have to figure out how it works. Oh my God, Hector, so much for this +8 energy.
Yeah, thank you. It was fun.
+8 for someone who doesn't know is the maximum speed that you can put on the turntable.
I've been asked that thing so many times.
Really. Yeah, yeah. So thank you so much for this +8 energy.
Thank you.
It's really now I feel like going to a club to party.
Yeah. I feel like that all the time.
Yeah. So thank you so much. No. And I feel like we need to do a part two in the future because I didn't play like even half of the records that I prepared.
Neither did I.
So we do part two next year, 2021. If clubs don't reopen, we keep on. And thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in.
Thank you, guys.
And we see us next Wednesday.